Hello, Munif.
Hi.
What happened on May 9th? We had
on
a little
May
training.
9th, we had a little training, and I appreciate you were there after you were not feeling well at the day, but you made sure that you convinced yourself in your mind that you're feeling well, and still you were there to give us the training for our benefit. And on that day, we learned how to say no. And how, like, the thing is, like, most of us, when it comes to our parents, when it comes to our bosses, we say yes just for the sake of saying yes, out of the fear of respect, out of the fear of losing job, out of the fear of many things. And that's actually not right, because if you're gonna continue saying yes to everything, that will gather in your heart somewhere, and it will keep on gathering, and there will be a day when the lava will be burst, and at that particular day, they will eventually not feel good about it, and you will eventually be kicked out of everywhere. So it's better to say no in a certain way rather than saying no directly, and which leads to today's class, which was how to say no in a positive way. Like, for example, if you want someone to do your particular task, you go over there and you can say, I was wondering if you can do this for me. And that guy, if he's not able to do that at that particular time, he'll respond to you back, like, I appreciate you want me to do this right now, but I have a priority task. I appreciate you want me to do this right now. I'm doing this right now, which is a priority for me. Allow me 5 minutes, and I'll do that for you. Will that be okay with you? Something like that. So this is a positive way of doing it, and you are actually interacting and taking the other guy into confidence. However, you are saying no still, but you are taking the other guy into confidence, and now he's giving you the permission to do that. So how is he going to feel bad about it?
So how beneficial was it for the company today? What do you think?
Overall,
the learning
is. In fact, I guess it was very much beneficial, and I guess these kind of trainings have to be happened in all companies. And the reason is again same. If you trust your people, if you want your people to become an asset and not become a liability, because eventually what will happen? They will say yes, 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 and one day they will say, out of the guilt of not being able to do it, they will leave. And your asset will be finished. You need to train a new asset now. If you want to do this, then it's perfectly okay. You can continue having, your guys say no about it or yes about it. And if you don't want to do that, get these kinds of training, which will eventually help your people to groom it up, and will tell them to say no where they have to say no, where they can't do it. There is a power and an ability in the person, and once that ability is exhausted, the person cannot do it. So I guess it's very much beneficial overall for the company, for any company. So again, I would like to thank you on the behalf of Sup Technologies, and thank you.
Thank you. And let's say, just going to shoot this little video on the board, on our topic. So first of all, this is our entry point. I was wondering, this is heavy delivering request, and this is our topi point. I agree with you, I respect you, I appreciate your invitation or whatever that was, and you state whatever you want to say with an end attached to it, and then you are going to basically ask permission from the other person that it was okay. So all that basically is, we went through also the sandwich format and feedback. We also went through the significance of the but, of which means that whenever you say the word but, you cancel everything which was ever said before. So thank you so much. This is our learning for today. Thank you, Munif.
Thank you so much.